Thank you. We are in solidarity with Miriam in Sudan. But Miriam is a model for what happened daily in Islamic countries under Sharia law. Do you know 500 Coptic girls kidnapped through the last 3 years and disappeared and forced to convert to Islam? Do you know that 30,000 Syrian Christian killed through the last 3 years in Syria by Islamic groups, and hundreds of women are kidnapped in Syria or Christian in Syria also? Do you know that in Iraq, 77% of Iraqi Christians left Iraq through the last 2 decades. Now only 23% of Iraqi Christians stay in Iraq. Do you know 200,000 people, Christians, left Egypt in the last 3 years? Do you know 60% of Christians in Syria left Syria after what happened the last 3 years? So we face, as a minority in Islamic countries, we face a severe persecution. Remember, in four years ago Sudan, Jafar Nimeiri released Sharia law. At the same time, in Pakistan, Muhammad Diya al-Haq released Sharia law. And at the same time, in Saudi Arabia, Faisal released Sharia law. We suffering from Sharia law. Sharia law is against human rights, against the basic human rights. So we call all of us to support Christian minorities in Islamic countries. The whole Christian, remember what happened in Nigeria. Nigeria now hundreds of people killed. It's not hundreds of girls kidnapped. So the Miriam is just model of what happened in Islamic countries under Sharia law. What happened from Islamic groups, from Muslim Brotherhood and allies like Qaeda and the Islamic group in Iraq and Syria and Hezbollah. All these people are targeting Christians, are targeting our faith, our identity. We are the indigenous people. We are the oldest churches in the world. Iraq, Syria, Egypt, the oldest church, and also Israel, the oldest church in the world. Almost nil from the Christians now. Almost nil from the Christians. The land of our Old Testament prophets, the land of Jesus Christ, now almost empty from Christians, under heavy persecution from Islamic group, Islamic phenomena, Islamic awaken, this Islamic law. We face genocide, we face racism, Islamic law, heavy racism.